Greetings, this is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. Thanks once again for joining us, and thank you for subscribing and liking comments. I really appreciate comments made as well. Today's talk focuses on, I want to call it contrainvesting against Tesla. Bonjour, Vigates, Vistes, Nochem, Osvai, Binen, Strasvice. Buongiorno, this is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. This past week, the first week of July, I was reading a CNBC article where a venture capitalist in Silicon Valley made the point that it might be worth considering contra-investing to Tesla's onslaught on the auto industry. What this is about is the fact that he raised the issue that in the United States, for example, there's a company called O'Reilly Auto Parts. There are other firms like Napa Auto Parts, AutoZone, etc., and all of them compete in the auto parts industry. What's happening right now is the fact that a detail about Tesla that's not discussed is the fact that vehicles like Tesla only need 17 parts in the engine compartment to drive the electric car process. So why this is a big deal is that an internal combustion engine typically goes about 2,000 parts, and these are the sort of replacement parts that places like O'Reilly, etc., are selling. So the problem becomes, as more and more owners go towards electric vehicles, there are going to be fewer parts needed by these individuals when it comes to repair and other issues, for example, oil changes. So as a result, he's forecasting that their stock prices, particularly as the Model 3 gets rolling and then competitors to it start arriving, it's going to incrementally start affecting the sales of these companies. And I think he's right on point. So what contrainvesting is about is the fact that you can actually do what's called buying puts or shorting, which are a couple of techniques one can do if you think the stock price of a company is going to decline. So I thought this was kind of fascinating. Kind of a sidebar note to this is if you're a Tesla owner and you don't have all-wheel or four-wheel drive, you may want to consider in that empty bay in the front of the vehicle either putting a spare tire or a couple of sacks of salt in there as a way to increase the weight, because it'll give you better balance across the vehicle on snow, etc., and you know, better traction throughout. So I thought this was an interesting idea because there are a lot of ways that you can make money based on research and understanding that you're getting, and one of them indeed can be contrainvesting. You know, our talks tend to be longer. This one is a short one, but I thought it was really interesting because it was clear to me based on the number of parts that Tesla has in their vehicles that there was going to be some contrainvesting opportunities. But I have to admit that I thought this was an interesting one because I was trying to figure out, there are companies like Delphi and other manufacturers in parts for GM and all the major makes, and I knew their stock prices were going to take a hit. But in terms of brands that are more obvious, I think that you know, places like the major auto shops are definitely places that are going to be harmed by the growth of Tesla and other competition in the electric space. This is a brief talk for today. I want to thank you again for visiting with us. This is Greg at Tesla Fan Insight. Please like and subscribe. Tschüss, macht's gut, au revoir, à tout à l'heure, le hitro, Khoda Hafez. Look forward to our next conversation.